In this video, we're going to show you everything that you need to know to assemble the Death Guard miniatures from the Dark Imperium box set. If you're new to the hobby, then this is the place to begin. But if you've got more experience, you might want to watch the video anyway, just to pick up some useful tips and tricks. Now, you need to get together all the tools that you need to assemble your miniatures, and that's exactly what I've done here. I've got a set of clippers to cut all the components out of the frames, and I've also got this tool here, which is called a mold line remover, and you'll see why that's useful shortly. I've also got a knife, and this is to get to any tricky to remove bits of plastic that I might need to remove. And I've also got a drill here, and this is to drill out the gun barrels, and again you'll see that later on. Now for glue, I'm going to be using plastic glue, and this is the perfect kind of glue for miniatures like this. And once you've got all these together, you're now ready for the next step, which is to have a read of the instruction booklet. I always recommend you do this before you cut out anything, just to make sure you're familiar with how all the components go together. And also, you just need to pick out which miniature you want to start with. Now I'm going to begin with one of the Plague Marines we've got in here, and you can see the components are labelled as C11 and C12. Now the C is to help you find the correct frame. We want frame C, which is the one I've got just here, and we need to find parts 11 and 12 on here. So you can see the frame down here is labelled as C, and 11 and 12 are up here. So there we are, 11, and there's number 12. Now it's always a good idea just to cut out the actual part that you need, so I'm going to start with part number C11. Now I'm going to use some clippers to remove this from the frame, and well, here's my set just here. And to use this, it's dead simple. All you do is find the part you want to cut out, and put the flat of the blade next to the part you want, and just snip your way through. Now it's always a good idea only to remove the part that you want, so that you don't get them all mixed up or even some parts lost. So what I'm going to do now is just remove this single piece from the frame, and then we'll move on. Once you've removed the component from the frame, have a close look at it for any mould lines on it. And we've got one on this. It goes up the front of the faceplate and across the top of the helmet and down the other side. Now this is just residue left over from the injection moulding process. And removing these mould lines is really simple, but it's a good idea that you do it as you spot these lines, so they don't show up once you paint your miniature. To remove them, what you need is the mould line removing tool, and using it is, well, that simple. All you've got to do is locate the mould line, then hold the tool at about 45 degrees against the part where the line is and just gently scrape it away like this. Now you might still see a little mark left over afterwards, but so long as it feels smooth, you won't notice that as soon as any paint's put on it. I've finished cleaning this component, and I've also cut out part C12, and I've cleaned it up as well. And with both these parts clean, we're ready to stick them together. Now before you put glue on anything, always test fit the components to make sure you know how they fit together and that they fit correctly. And you can see that's a good fit just there, so we're now ready to glue them. Now we're going to use plastic glue for this, and the way plastic glue works is it actually melts the plastic and then almost welds the two pieces into one. So you get a very strong join out of this, but because it does melt it, it can corrode detail if you get it onto those parts. So just be careful not to put on too much. So what I'm going to do is put some of this glue onto the areas the part's going to make contact with. So what I want to do is just get some of it just running all the way along these areas here. So a bit down there and on the inside of where the leg's going to go. And there we go. And with that done, we're now ready to put the parts together. Now this will take about 30 minutes to dry completely, but you'll feel it sticking very, very fast. So you don't need to wait around to put the next part on. Now that I've stuck these two parts of the body together, we've got both the legs assembled, so we're ready at this point to attach the miniature to the base. I always like to do this as soon as possible on the model because it just makes it more stable and easier to put all the other components on. And doing this is just like gluing anything else. All you need to do is put a small amount of glue on each part that's going to make contact. So just a little dollop underneath each foot there like that, and then all we've got to do is attach it to the base. And it's always a good idea to make the model as central over the base as you can just to make it more stable. So with this done, I'm now going to carry on building this Plague Marine. I've added the rest of the components, and this Plague Marine is fully built. And at this point, there's an optional thing you can do if you want to, and that is to drill out the gun barrels. You don't have to, but I think it looks particularly cool. And to do it, what you need is just one of these drills. And all you've got to do is put in the smallest drill bit, and then you just position it over the center of the gun barrel there like that, and just gently start drilling it in. You don't have to go very far, just a short distance down, but it looks really cool if you do this. And with the gun barrel drilled out, this Plague Marine is complete. And with that, you really have everything that you need to know to build any of the miniatures in this set. They're different shapes and sizes, of course, but they all follow the same techniques and principles to put together. There is one miniature in the set, though, that's a bit more complex than the others, and this is the Foetid Bloat Drone. When you're doing this, early on, you want to assemble the three main components of the body, which you can see I've done just here, the front plate and the two sides of the body. And at this point, you must glue it onto the base. And the reason for this is the other components that fit to it have quite small fittings. And so if you just stick them on and rest it to dry, you'll see that they'll tend to bend. So for example, I've got the turbine that goes on the side just here. You can see the fitting is quite small. If I was to glue that like this, because the plastic glue takes about half an hour to dry, if it's resting, this will bend out of place. If, however, you stick it to the base, it'll be nice and stable as it dries. So I definitely recommend that you do that first. I've completed assembling the photo bloat drone, and you can see some of those small fittings, especially on the guns, but by sticking it to the base first, it was made much, much easier to assemble. So the key things to remember about assembling your miniatures from this set are that you should always read your instruction booklet before you do anything, and then only cut out the components that you need and be sure to clean them one at a time before attaching them to the miniature. Finally, remember to use plastic glue, and remember this glue takes about 30 minutes to dry completely. But really, that's all there is to it. Now, we really hope you guys enjoy building your miniatures from Dark Imperium, and well, have fun playing with them too, and we'll see you again very soon.